There were things happening in Europe and the Pacific Theater and the United States all at the same time. World events don't happen in isolation. When humans were first stepping foot on the moon in July 1969, there were soldiers fighting and dying in Vietnam. In April 1942, you had fighting in both European and Pacific theaters. And on April 18th, the Toronto Maple Leafs hockey team won the Stanley Cup championship, and Lieutenant Colonel James Doolittle led a raid on Japan. This was thought up soon after the Japanese attacked Pearl Harbor. The idea was to bomb Japanese industrial centers to not only damage them, but to also wage psychological warfare and boost American morale. At this point in the war, the United States didn't have bases close enough or bombers that could fly far enough to reach Japan. The idea was for B-25 bombers to launch from and return to an aircraft carrier. Unfortunately, testing showed that the bombers were not able to land back on the carrier. Instead, they would have to drop their bombs and try to get away and land in China. Lieutenant Colonel James Doolittle was chosen to lead the attack. 16 B-25 bombers with a crew of 5 were loaded onto the aircraft carrier, the USS Hornet. Navy ships and aircraft from the USS Enterprise protected them as they cruised toward Japan. On April 18th, these bombers took off when they were 650 miles from Japan, much further than planned because they were discovered and wanted to keep the element of surprise. Of the 16 bombers that took off, 15 had to crash land or bail out because they ran out of fuel. 7 of these brave soldiers were killed in the raid. The result of the raid was not a lot of damage in Japan, but it was inspirational to the United States. The morale of soldiers fighting and those at home is always an important part of warfare. You may be wondering why I'm standing in front of the space shuttle to talk about Jimmy Doolittle and World War II. Doolittle served as an inspiration for service members, including one who earned his wings of gold as a naval aviator and went on to become an astronaut, Scott Tingle.
A hero of mine was Jimmy Doolittle. What a brave man. You know, he's involved in aviation early on. He was aggressive enough. He went to MIT and got himself a PhD and then came back and led our forces on the Tokyo raid. You know, he flew an Air Force bomber off of a United States Navy aircraft carrier. And when you want to talk about a team of professionals making things happen, that story in itself is just so amazing.
You just saw how Jimmy Doolittle inspired NASA astronaut Scott Tingle. Who inspires you? Let us know down in the comments section. Be sure to give STEM in 30 a follow on Facebook and Twitter, and also subscribe to the National Air and Space Museum's YouTube channel for more videos like this.